Hello and welcome to this next vlog post, now into week 5 of the base mesocycle. And things are really upping this week in terms of weight training. I'm doing much more of a bodybuilder split, and really probably the volume essentially is a lot higher than maybe what you normally would do within a base cycle. But the reason I'm doing this is for another training goal that I have sort of over the next couple of months, which is really essentially to, I want to trim some body fat ahead of the main challenge going into next year. So that's why I'm doing it. So I'll be posting a lot of different exercises over the next few weeks that are involved within my training there. The main real base cycle that I'm still doing is for my running. That's still at a very low level. I'm really just working on heart rate zone 2 still. There's not been much change in that from the last couple of weeks, so that's going to continue quite slowly over the next few weeks whilst I'm still in this cycle. So I suppose that's the main base cycle training I'm doing, if you like, along with all the weight training that's been added in as a kind of like sub sort of shorter term goal to help with the longer term goal. So what did we look at last week? There was bench press. That is obviously a very common exercise, and quite often people will get maybe stuck or in a bit of a rut with it. As well as looking at the pause reps that you can do. Now, I just did a very brief sort of 1 second pause at the bottom. You can do that for longer. You can pause 3, 4, 5 seconds. Obviously, the longer you pause, the harder it'll be. The longer your muscles are under tension, so you will need to use lighter weights for that. It can be used for strength and hypertrophy. I would mostly use it for aiming for hypertrophy, just with the muscle damage. But I mean, you can use it for both. Really depends what your training goals are. But I think it's also great for, as I said, if you are stuck in a rut or you can't kind of get past a certain point, it's good to bring in a bit of a change, and that's one way that you can do that. I'll be looking at some different chest exercises as well, sort of going forward, because as I say, I'm doing a lot more volume right now than I have for a long time. So for the first time in, I don't know, months, I can't even remember, probably not years, but a long time anyway, I'm doing decline and incline bench with a bar as well, all in the same workout. So really, as I say, it's really, the volume is really upping there. What else did we look at was the the Bulgarian split squat, which has never been a friend of mine. I don't think it really is a friend of anyone. That exercise burns, but it is really good, and it can be used as it can be a replacement for squats there could be multiple reasons why you can't do squats, particularly back squats, if you've had any sort of mobility issues or injuries, especially around the knee. Then it can be a great exercise for targeting the quads. Similarly though, as I said, because I'm doing volume at the moment, I'm doing them after squats, so the burn in the quads is very real. But again, great exercise, so one that you should try in your routine. Going forward this week, we'll be looking at some different exercises, but one I really want to look at is the lat pull down. This is a really widely used exercise. It's very common, is what I'm trying to say. But it can be done wrong a lot of the time. So I wanted to look at the technique for that. Now, the main muscles it works are the trapezius and the lats, but also the tres minor, which is sort of just at the sort of below the shoulder blade, and the rotator cuffs is in the shoulder as well. These two muscles are essential for stabilizing the shoulder in a sort of upper body pressing movement. So the lat pull down helps work those muscles as well. Now, when you're doing the movement, now this is according to the National Academy for Sports Medicine for Athletes. If you pull the bar down to chest, flexing your elbows, so basically bend your elbows, you should squeeze your shoulder blades together and down, and you should feel a slight stretch in your pecs. You want to keep your trunk stable as well and avoid swinging. So that's the main sort of teaching points for that, but so we'll look at that in more detail in the video at some point this week. So that's all I think from me for now. just a bit of a quicker video this week, really just touching base on what we did last week and going forward as well. I did want to say I'm changing up my nutrition as well. Main reason for that was really just I felt like I was getting a bit of a rut with the food that I was eating. I tend just to eat what works for me, and I've got a lot of sort of lack of time in my life, so it makes it easy if I just have similar meals a lot of time. But I just wanted to throw in a bit of a change, especially we just wanted to trim off a bit of body fat over the next few weeks. I thought it'd be good to try out some different meals, so I've been doing some cooking as well, or some, I do cooking anyway, but I've been doing some extra batch cooking, so we'll see how that goes. But that's a roundup for now. Hope you enjoy the video. Catch you again soon.